Hi, my name is Shay. Welcome to my channel, and I'm having a mental breakdown in quarantine.
Help me, please.
Now, I know you're not sitting there with Cheeto dust underneath your fingernails judging me. Judging me? No.
Daddy?
Do I look?
I don't know how y'all doing, but I am not doing my best. You know, I'm not thriving here in quarantine. I'm trying to stay positive, get through this, but
it is hard.
Now, we do have some positives. I feel like Netflix and Hot Cheetos has been my best friend this entire quarantine. Y'all can hate if you want, but I'm just saying, Netflix has been there for me through the tough times and the great times. Now, if you're just like me, you probably wake up black and beautiful.
Hold up, wait a minute, it's a 22. Pew, pew, pew.
Probably wake up at noon, binge watch Netflix all day, go to bed, to wake up at noon again and binge watch Netflix all day. I'm just saying, is that not your routine? Am I wrong? You've probably seen every single show Netflix has out there. You are a valuable individual who values your Netflix time. You don't have time to waste on a half-assed season getting through 1 to 3 episodes and realize the show's shit, right? So I'm here to make your life a little bit easier. You're welcome. I've put together a list of my six top favorite Netflix shows and movies that you can binge in a day. Go crazy. Cheeto dust all over y'all. You won't even want to get up to go to the bathroom. This is in no particular order, and I've included the trailers so you don't have to go and search them up yourselves. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Don't forget to hit that like button, hit subscribe to join the channel to see more videos like this. For a show that you can binge in a day, then The Island is the show for you. I'm telling you, I could not stop watching this. 10 people wake up on an island with no memory of how they got there or who they are. They don't even know their own names. As they try to recollect all their memories, they realize that the island is not what it seems. As they group together to get back to home, wherever home is, they realize that the island is putting them through psychological and physical challenges. The show is classified as a sci-fi thriller, and it is not what I thought it would be. Every episode has a twist, and it keeps you clicking. Next episode, next episode, next episode.
Mr. Chase, can you please tell us the first thing you remember from the simulation?
Where am I?
Nobody can remember anything at all about how we woke up here.
Then what? I mean, our plane went down?
I don't know. I just want to figure this thing out.
We haven't seen half the shit this island's gonna throw at us. We're gonna die out here. We have to be ready.
Or we try to get out of here.
It's all about to get a whole lot more intense now.
If you do something wrong, the island, it pays you back.
Something's off with her. Check her.
Get her!
Did you see something too?
I think I'm finally beginning to understand the rules of this place.
If you die in there, you're dead out here too.
Each choice determines the next challenge.
You think they've got a chance in there?
Not if I got anything to say about it.
In a fight for survival.
I just remembered my lunch.
Next show is for those of you that think watching CSI is a personality trait. If you find serial killers and psychopaths interesting, then this is a show for you. The show is set in the late 1970s and you follow along two FBI agents as they interview serial killers to solve open cases. The whole concept is who would know a killer better than another killer. This show is classified as a crime mystery thriller, so they threw in a few couple of famous serial killers.
I mean, imagine what it takes to bludgeon someone to death. The lust for control, the feeling of arousal, the decision to humiliate her corpse. How could you possibly get that from an ordinary police report?
I can choke down the bile, manufacture empathy,
when our subjects are at least informative.
We decided no one was beneath our contempt.
I'm trying to warn you. Your attitude is going to bite you in the ass.
So young to be ruining people's lives.
We need to know exactly how worried we need to be.
This awful, raging, eating feeling is inside me.
It's not our job to commiserate with these people. It is our job to electrocute them.
We can't like everything we do. We're talking to serial killers.
If any of this is going to work, we need to talk to more subjects.
More!
You want truffles? You got to get in the dirt with the pigs.
No. We don't. We are the FBI.
I have a show where there's no way in hell that you'd ever like it, but then you give it a chance and you're like, oh wow, that wasn't actually that bad. This was the show for me. A friend actually recommended it to me and I binged it. So the story follows a young girl who was accused of lying about an assault. You follow along two female FBI agents as they handle the case. This is actually the one show that I actually did cry, and it takes you through a wave of emotions that you never knew you had. This is classified as a crime drama.
I know this is hard, but I need to ask you some questions about what happened.
He tied my hands. He said if I screamed, he'd kill me.
No signs of forced entry. Doors and windows were locked. No DNA. Not a single neighbor saw or heard a thing.
He brought a blindfold, but nothing to tie her with. Would a shoelace even hold her?
You think Marie made up the attack?
I'm pretty positive that it happened.
Pretty positive or positive?
They just kept asking me the same question. How come your story doesn't add up? I wanted to go home.
I don't have a victim here. It's bogus. She made it up.
We're on the scene of a violent attack. Police say a masked assailant broke in while the victim was sleeping.
He said you need to be more protective of yourself.
Black mask, bindings, early morning attacks.
I think he's done this before.
Aurora. 18 months ago, intruder, black mask, backpack, tied her up, took photos. To date, has not been caught.
You see the pattern.
There's a rape, new evidence, new leads, and then one by one, they dry up until he hits again.
This one, they're figuring out on her own.
What if he knows stations don't talk to each other? As long as he only hits once in each town?
You could have detectives from 8 different departments investigating 8 identical rapes with no clue. They're all chasing the same guy.
Victims are all over the map. Old, young, different races. So he doesn't have a type.
Sure he does. Women who live alone.
This guy is out there preying on the most vulnerable women he can find. Where is the outrage? This is not something people get over. This is something they carry with them forever.
This one is from our horror buff. So anyone who likes vampires, this is a modern take on the classic story by Bram Stoker, Dracula. It is psychological, suspenseful, scary. It is just everything. And the one thing I like about the show is that it is a comedy as well. Just the way the character dialogue is created, oh my god, I was laughing so hard. There's one season out so far, but there's 3 episodes and they are long. And trust me, you will be begging for more, because honestly, I thought they weren't long enough. This story follows the main character who is trapped in Dracula's maze-like castle. If you really like vampires and horror and like Van Helsing type shows, then you really like this. And if you do watch this, come back and tell me, do you find the character Dracula hot? Because I do. It's just something about power, just ooh, bite me.
Blood is everything you need. Only in blood do we find the truth. And I will find it.
There is a corruption passing through this world.
I wish to know everything that occurred in the time you spent with him.
He is a monster. He is the devil himself.
I could be wrong, but I think you are having a nightmare. I'm going to destroy everything you love.
There's one thing that he fears. We must discover it.
All you have to do. Invite me in.
are you?
If you're looking for something chilling, dark, and scary, something that keeps you up at night just thinking about things, then this show is the one for you. This story follows a police officer when six people arose from their graves in the middle of the night. Having no memory of how or why they died. The whole story follows around these characters as pieces and little clues of their history and how they died arises. Each episode has its own little twist and turn.
Can you pop out of the cemetery?
I just had a call about some disturbance there.
The people at the cemetery.
They've come back to life.
I thought you were a zombie, but you talk.
What? Of course I bloody talk.
The people listed on the tombstones match up with you. Charles Ernest Thompson. You've been dead for almost 100 years.
Holy Mother of God.
This is my wife, Kate. She died 2 years ago.
We're all risen again.
For what purpose?
I remembered something. I was in a fight.
You were murdered.
Who exactly are you hiding us from?
We got to the bridge. Both of them were bleeding from the eyes. We headed out by the North Road, and the same thing happened again.
We need to know for certain if you're all trapped here.
That's you! Patrick Fitzgerald died 150 years ago.
Why am I back?
I don't know, but I'm gonna take care of you.
That's my friend. That's Sarah.
How long did you wait till you hooked up with her?
I thought you were dead.
This isn't a miracle. It's a punishment. Hello, Sarah.
I know that you never really got over losing Kate, but I'm not gonna share you.
This is no dream. This is a bloody nightmare.
She told you why.
Stop! All of us need to put things right. Our past, let those we left behind know the truth.
Next show is based on a comic book and it's actually Canadian. And when I tell you I was obsessed with the show, I was obsessed with the show. This show follows the main character. She wakes up after a 5-year coma to discover that the world is overtaken by vampires. And she discovers that her blood holds the immunity to being a vampire and can turn vampires back into humans. Joel follows her along as she tries to fight these creatures and return the world back to what it once was. I have a huge crush on the army guy named Axel. He is so fine.
I had a dream once. Our world had ended. Vampires had taken over. And I was the only one that could stop them. It was no dream. I'm nothing special.
Somebody thought you were.
You want me? Here I am.
That's it for the video, guys, and I really hope you enjoyed that. I have one favor to ask. I am a horror girl. I love anything gory, horror, thriller, psychological thriller, anything like that. So if you think there's a show that I would love, please leave me your list down below of your recommendations, and I would love to watch them. Your girl is bored too, so help a sister out. Love y'all. Hit that like button to support me and subscribe to join the channel. If you want more videos like this, let me know down below in the comment section and I have more shows to recommend to you. This was a real struggle to record. I'm not gonna lie. I messed up all the words. If you guys want to see more of my Netflix recommendations, I can't even speak. It's end the video, Shay. We can't do this. You know, we can't do this right now. If y'all want to see some more Netflix recommendations, Hooked on Phonics, we learned this, okay? Let me know down below. I have a list already ready and I should make that video and upload, okay? Hit that subscribe button. Bye, I'll see you guys later.
Wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew, pew, pew.